A very interesting artist of the Amdo region is Garu Pandita Lobsang Sherab. He was born in the 17th century and lived most likely into the early 18th century. And he studied in Lhasa region for a while, but his hometown, his home area is the Rebkong area of Amdo, also called Tongren, and in Qinghai province. And he was famous for painting the walls, murals on the walls of a chapel in Nyentok Monastery. And then there's also another room. There's two rooms that I'm aware of where he painted murals. And the murals are really quite amazing because they give us a very clear idea of a date and a place and who the artist was. And we have a fair amount of information that is now coming available with studies that are being done by local scholars in the Rebkong area. Now, the murals themselves, the subjects in one of the chapels, the subjects are meditational deities and protectors, some Buddhas. In another chapel, it's more biographies, it's historical teachers. And the quality of the work is extremely good. But what kind of style are you going to apply to it? Now, in modern times now, I mean, people generally say, oh, it's a Menri or New Menri style. Well, Menri, original Menri and New Menri are actually two quite different styles. One of my informants from actually 2003 working in the area, one of my educated informants who was writing a book on the history of Rebkong in Tibetan language, told me that Garu Pandita painted in a mixed Menri and Khyenri style. So we really do have to look at the paintings very carefully to see what are the characteristics of the original Menri, New Menri, and Khyenri to really determine what kind of painting style is claimed to be the original source or the early training of Garu Pandita. But what is really interesting is that we actually have an artist where it may be his own style, and we really shouldn't be looking too far back to find out what his influences were, but concentrate more on what is at hand and what we're actually looking at on the walls of the chapels. Now, I've been talking about murals, but we also have many examples of scroll works that have been preserved in homes and the family home of Garu Pandita, which still exists in the Rebkong area. So this field of studying the artist Garu Pandita Lobsang Sherab and his works, his body of works, it's really unfolding, and I'm sure in the future there will be a dedicated book just on Garu Pandita, the artist.